Hi Ma, good morning. Welcome back to SWOT class. So in last class we started the introduction of unit 2, that is designing of architecture along with the styles, and we divided the unit is divided in terms of two parts. So one is designing and one is the styles. So in the last class, what is a designing? We learn what is the position of a designing in total life cycle of an architecture building. So where is the position, ma? So it is after requirements. So after gathering of the requirements, we have to start the designing process. Okay, if you want to start a design, we should know the first drivers. What are the drivers? Goals. Okay, so if you set any goal to build an architecture to fulfill your requirement, so automatically this can be called as a drivers. Okay, and also these drivers are nothing but the goals should always depends upon the quality along with the performance issues. If both are not met for any architecture building, automatically your goal is not going to be fulfilled. What is it? So one is a quality, one is a performance or functionality. Okay, so first is we started a concept called as ADD. ADD. What is a ADD, ma? Attribute driven design. So what is the attribute here? The quality drivers or performance or functionality drivers. Okay, so we have to check in any path of this architecture designing whether these attributes are meeting to a requirement or not. Okay, so we started that topic and we're at here beginning ADD. If you want to start attribute driven design, means you want to collect the attributes. Based upon the attributes, you want to start design. First of all, you have to identify the what are the attributes or in terms of drivers. See, so ADD depends on identification of the drivers and can start as soon as all of them are known. If you ready to start along with the drivers, yes, your design has been started. Okay, so what are these? What are these drivers? What are these? Better understanding of the requirements or result of changing requirements. So if you are able to understand what are the requirements, requirements means your goal only your requirement. For example, I want to become a collector. Okay, that is your goal, that is your requirement. So we are able to do the verify your requirements, or if you want to change a requirement, that change have to know you perfectly. We should not deviate from that later. Okay, if it is so, it is called as attribute driven design starting point. Right, ma? ADD steps. So what are the basic ADD steps? See, in any ADD steps, we have to start with the decomposition, because we can't to start a design. For example, we have given garage doors, garage door example, opener. Okay, so can you able to start garage door opener like that in one step? No, we can't. First of all, we have to find out the sensors, the algorithm to find any person or obstacle to open the door. Okay, if there is anybody inside before closing your garage, okay, you should find out in some distance so that the person is there. Okay, so this is one requirement. Sensor is a one requirement. After detecting, you have to identify the person or any non-living thing. Third requirement. Okay, so like this, and moreover, it have to stop working. Means closing the door, it have to stop closing the door automatically. Fourth requirement. So single architecture called as a garage door opener, is divided in terms of multiple steps. Because here also the first step, the foremost step is decomposition. Decomposition of your architecture in terms of modules. Okay, later we have to start working on that. Later we have to find out the main drivers. Later we have to start what is the patterns. Later we have to find out the sub steps or child. Later we have to find out the interfaces or views. Okay, later we have to find out the views finally. Okay, if you want to do all this, we have to repeat the same steps for n number of times. Okay, so these are nothing but the additive steps. What are those? Decomposition. After decomposition, we have to start identifying your driver's concept. Later, we have to identify your interfaces in terms of channels and interfaces, communication, all this. Okay, so let us start. First one, choose a module to decompose. So which one do you want to start decomposes? First thing. Second one, refine the module according to these steps. If you want to do any changes, see, automatically we have to go to changes. No doubt at all in that, okay? Choose architectural drivers from the set of concrete quality scenarios and functional requirements. Yeah. So based upon these two features, what are those quality and functional requirements? Choose your architectural drivers. What is your motive to behind to design your architecture? That's a big issue, right? Next one. Choose an architectural pattern. In what way you want to start? Okay, pattern means the first step, this one, second step, this one, third step, this one. For example, garage door opener. Can you identify your object directly? No. You have to identify, first of all, distance. In which distance it can able to identify the obstacle. Whether that obstacle is going to be moving or not moving. Static. If it is a static, we don't no need to worry about this garage door opener. It can do its work. Okay. If it is a moving thing, how many seconds I have to calculate whether it is a moving or not? Right. So if it is a mode, for example, a ball came, it is rolled for so and so time. Okay, and it is stopped somewhere without moving. Means it is a non-living thing. Because it is not moving after some time. So what is the time period I have to check whether it is a living or non-living thing identification, right? So like this is a pattern. Yes, instantiate modules and allocate functionality. So what is your modules work? What modules work? What is their functionality? We have to define here, okay? So for that you represent the multiple views. See, for anything we have to check what are the basic constraints we have, what are the basic functionalities we have. That's enough. Functionality, constraint. If anything have to work based upon the constraints only. Okay, so if there is no constraint, how the functionality can met? See, I want to delivering a lecture for you in terms of a video. My functionality is delivering a lecture to you in terms of a video. But what is my constraint for time period? So I don't have any constraint. Can you able to listen to my class for more than 35 minutes or 45 minutes? No, can't be. So my functionality is delivering a lecture, but there is a constraint. So if you're able to identify these two features, automatically, yeah, your design is going to be perfect. Right? See. So that one is going to read in the C point. D. Different interfaces of the child modes. Yeah. After decomposition on order, after identifying this quality attributes, you can start chain nodes. So if you divided two parts of a single part, we have to find out the interface. What is the communication between these two? It is going to be friendly way, or it is going to be either a master slave concept. Master slave. Okay. See this last one. Verify and refine use cases and quality scenarios and make them constraints for the chain nodes. Yes. So where it can be uses. These small modules are chain modules. Okay, we have to check, and finally, if there is any constraints you want to put on that, let us go with the constraints. Okay, ma. So these are the two steps we have been. So for first one, the decomposition. Later, we have to find out lot of steps in terms of five steps. And final third step is repeat the steps above every module that needs further decomposition. So we have to repeat the same for n number of times based upon your requirement. See, choose a model to decompose. First step, choose a model to decompose. The following, see, the model you want to decompose is, for example, which one I can take? Yeah, all of you likes cricket, right? So if you verify the cricket, architecture of a cricket is a single thing. Single model, no. So we have to find out the models first. Okay, what are the models first? We have to find out a team. That team selection is based upon your experience along with the presentation, okay, the quality and the how they act based upon the situation. So these are all the factors. Okay, so first thing, so selection of the team, that selection of the team also dependent upon 3 to 4 factors which I discussed later. We have to find out the opponent or opposite team to play with it. Second model. Okay, after that we have to set goal. Okay, we have to set goal between it is a 20 overs or 15 overs. Where is the location? What is the time period? Okay, and where is the venue? So this is a third model, if you can see all this at one place. Finally, so what is the total time we can give for in a day? It can be able to compute in 1 day or 2 day or 3 day. If it is, so the venue is going to be same place or different places. See, just in a fraction of seconds we got n number of models. Okay, so if you see a single word called as architecture called as a cricket, it is system. What is system? See, the cricket is divided in terms of team selection, gaming, opponent team selection, location changing or location identification. So these are all called as subsystems. So it is also one of the module, right? You have to accept. Okay, so like this, a module decomposition is maybe the big to small or small to small or from small to very very small, right? We can't see, yeah, it is from big to small only, from the biggest architecture to smaller modules. We can't say. So after dividing the big architecture to smaller modules, if you want to divide these modules into submodules, what you can do? We have to divide. Right? So what the other one to convey is, these are all the modules, either big system or subsystem or submodules. Okay, the decomposition typically starts with, where it can be starts? It is always start with the system, the big one. Later it divide into subsystems. Later, if you want to divide more into submodules, we have to remember that. Okay. So in your example, the garage door opener is a system. Yes. Where you want to start your work, the garage door opener only. What are the functionalities? I repeat. What are those? Whether it is working properly or not, we have to check. Whether it is able to find out the obstacle, we have to find out. Whether it is working on the constraint time limit or not. Whether it is opening and closing or working or not. Opening the door, closing the door. Okay. Right. So once constraint at this level is opener must interoperate with the home information system. So it should be very helpful. So like as which we use in the houses. Right. So refine the model according to these steps. So we learn about the first step, decomposition in terms of system, submodules or subsystem. Later we start the second step. In this we have 5 things, right? A, B, C, D. First one. Choose the architectural drivers from the set of concrete quality scenarios and functional requirements. What are the drivers we have? From the beginning I am saying it is either functional requirements or quality requirements, right? That shape the architecture. If you don't have any requirements like this, why you are starting your architecture? What is the use of your architecture, right? Yeah, so in our example, the 4 scenarios we have shown are architectural drivers. So in the last class, I explained about the 4 scenarios which I just discussed with you regarding the garage or door opener. In your example, what is over in our example? Garage door opener. What are the main 4 scenarios? The first one is opening and the closing door. Next one is a processor. The next one is a time constraint. And next one is a final functionality, where it is a closing the door or not. These are the 4. Okay, we have to check those only were drivers, right? So if you don't have any of these 4 drivers, what is the use of the garage door opener? Right. Second, choose after verifying these drivers, we have to start with the architectural patterns. Right. Choose an architectural pattern that satisfies the architectural drivers. Which one I have to start as a first step? Which one I have to start as a second step? Third step, fourth step. I have 4 scenarios or 4 drivers. I have to put in order, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. Which one I have to? First. See, for each quality there are identifiable tactics. He is saying about the tactics. Tactics means your thought, your idea. Say if you want to cheat a faculty in the classroom, right? While class is going on in the classroom, what is your tactics you want to play? You will just act like this, staying like this. Okay, of course you are not listening in the class. Okay, for example, any faculty ask a question to you, a query to you in the classroom about your concept which is running in the class. Can you able to answer? No, you will try to play something. Oh, this is ma'am, that is ma'am. But maybe not, because you are not listening in the class. So like this, on what tactics you have to concentrate so that your pattern is going to be getting perfectly. Each tactic is designed to realize one or more quality attributes only. Of course, every tactic is for quality attributes only, I'm saying. Because without these attributes, what is the use of your tactic? What is your quality attribute in the class? You don't want to listen in your class, you want to be set free of your mind. Okay, for this you are playing the tactics like this. But for us, as architecture, what is your tactic? What is the need of the tactic here? To get the good architecture, right? So in order to get the good architecture, what is ultimate drivers? Quality attributes or functional attributes only. From there they got requirements only as a former step for architecture design, right? So in architecture design, a composition of many such tactics is used to achieve a balance between required multiple qualities, of course. But here we have two types of architects always. One is a performance, one is a modifiability. What is a performance means? Whether your module is working properly or not, checking. Modifiability means, see, if you did some module with some functionality, but if you are not able to change later, see, you have set to verify an obstacle for 3 seconds here. But unfortunately, 3 seconds time is not one person is coming, moving object. He fell down suddenly. He is not able to move for 3 seconds. So what the garage door sensor will treat him as a non-living thing. So it will leave that person in the garage only and it will lock the system. So that person will dead. Maybe he met with an heart attack. We don't know, right? So we have to change later. Suddenly if he moved, how much time he has been moved, in what angle. Okay, for example, ball is coming, he used to roll directly, but the person is coming, we have to move our hands and legs, right? Like that we have to change. Okay, the performance and modifiability as a critical quality attributes as part of a architectural drivers. Yeah, what are the modifiability tactics where we can change this tactics? So it should be localized. The changes should be at the in local system only. It should not affect the outside your local system, right? So that modification should affect the functionality of one module only, should not affect the function of the another module, right? Prevent the ripple effect. If there is any change, it should not get back, it should not react. Okay, and third one, defer binding means we have to check whether the bonding is going to be verified or not. Okay, the primary tactic is localized changes. So every change should be within the module only. It should not face any problem outside of your module. So these are the performance tactics. Next one is modifiable tactics. Performance tactics are, the performance means your resource demand, whether you are able to achieving your demand for resources or not, and your resource arbitration. Now what is the arbitration means? Performing. Okay, so after getting demand, after satisfying your demand, whether that resource is performing well or not, we have to check. What is this arbitration? English meaning is, see, performing, we have another word also. Performing is better. Performing. Okay, so architectural pattern with tactics. So for this, they have given some examples how they divide their work in terms of performance and non-performance. See, it is a user interface. The total architecture is very in terms of one is a performance computation, one is a non-performance, performance, non-performance. So non-performance, if you are not able to do that work, who will do that? So virtual machine will do that. So on virtual machine, automatically we have a software. What is the software? GCC we are going to learn, hypervisor. Okay, virtual machine monitor application will be there, which will take care of all the hardware and the software processor capabilities. Okay, if you want to do anything, we have to do start with the scheduler only. The scheduler only will verify which one we have to start first and which one we have to start next. Okay, see, this is what is the diagram of architectural pattern that utilizes tactics to achieve garage door driver. Okay, your user interface, what is the performance, what is the non-performance, and what is your virtual machine, and means hidden thing, no need to show to you. Okay, no need to visible to you. Scheduler, right? So this is the following tactics. What are the tactics it is going to be achieved? Semantic coherence and information heading. So some of the information we are not able to communicate with the system. Okay, for example, a user is using any garage door opener, you no need to know about the code, you no need to know about the syntax and semantics. So all these hidden, but who will work behind that? It is a virtual machine. For example, the garage door opener, we have to recharge for 20 to 30 minutes of time every day. If the recharge is drying, automatically you have to show some signal to us about this power off. Let us start with a red bulb, small LED bulb. So if you got glow from that, automatically what you have to think? So it is going to be drying, so we have to recharge it, right? Like this. Increase computational efficiency. Whenever there is a performance critical computations, automatically we can improve the performance. The contrast, next one is scheduler. Who is the scheduler? Who will take care of all the schedules to start and to wind up? The performance critical computation should be scheduled to ensure the achievement of timing deadline. That is the second point, patterns. So patterns always depends upon tactics only. Without tactics, we can't arrange those modules or drivers in order. For those, how many tactics we have? One is a performance, one is a attribute. One is a performance, one is a modifiability. Okay, instantiate modules and allocate functionality. As you are divide in terms of or identify the drivers, we have to start your allocation of your functionalities. After allocation, we have to start, that is, initiate your working of modules. So first one, instantiate module. Next, allocate functionality. Final one is a represent architecture with use. Let us start with the instantiate module. So here, what is the main module's work? That is communication and sensor interactions. It have to communicate with the outside environment. How? Based upon the sensors only, right? So who is going to work this? Virtual machine only. Virtual machine only. We don't need to worry about the inner details. We have to start our modules, that is garage door opener, this switch on, it have to start. So whenever there is a working without your intervention, working of a system without your intervention means there is a virtual machine only automatically behind that. Okay, so the virtual machine is also based upon working of application. Okay, so have more than one module, we know about this. Next, in garage door opener example, what the performance means? What is your functionality? We have to define functionality here, right? So performance critical section. What is the performance critical section here? Responsible for managing obstacle detection and halting your garage door. Yeah, you can check your performance like that only. See, if any person is coming towards the door before closing the garage and you are not able to find out that person, he shut down your garage, then what, it is performing well? No, it is not, no. So we have to check. Yes, it is its functionality of the garage. So this functionality has a deadline. Of course, it's a 3 second, 5 second, 6 second, that is up to you. Then what is a non-performance critical section? What is a non-performance critical section means? The processor, all thing, no need to verify that. It manages the normal rising and lowering of the door. See, the any functionality of a door is just you have to rise and lower the door. Based upon that, we can't say it is performing well, because it have to detect something, right? So it has no timing deadline. Did it have any timing deadline? No, na. So the diagnosis capability is also non-performance critical only. The diagnosis, actually the diagnosis capability for performance only, but other saying performance or diagnosis means verifying, checking. So virtual machine responsibilities, sir. What are the virtual machine responsibilities? Communication only, interfacing only. Okay, it have to take the data from you. It have to check to, it have to convey the same to main system or module. You have to check the functionality, later you have to respond to you. So all these are working without your intervention, right? So who will do all this? Virtual machine monitor under based upon virtual machine. See, after dividing a big module in terms of four things, what is one is we have to define user interface, one is a performance, one is a non-performance, one is a virtual machine, and one is a what is that schedule. We can divide further. See this. This is first level decomposition of garage door opener. See this. The user interface under non-performance, if you observe this, under non-performance, what we got? One is a diagnosis, one is a raising or lowering the door. Under performance, what we got? Obstacle detection. We have to, that is our theme, obstacle detection. Under virtual machine, what are the main works of the virtual machines? One is a communication, one is in terms of how it is going to communicate, in terms of sensor or actuator, like an agent in the artificial intelligence. So we have one more component called the scheduler that guarantees deadline. So higher level modules got functionality. What is the functionality? Diagnosis, raising, lowering door as a non-performance critical sections. Obstacle detection as a performance critical section. See, we are identifying our qualities, right? So this is non-performance quality, this is a performance quality attribute, this is a hidden concept attribute, virtual machine, and this is a scheduler attribute. We identified our system, right? So we got one step, that is A. So second one is allocate functionality. Now we have to, after dividing this, we have to allot some functionality. So that functionality may be either, as we divided in the big one in two parts, automatically we have to set the functionality, communication, whether it is going to be producer or consumer. One will produce or give input, one will take, either from this to this or this to this. That is one thing. Or one will work based upon the instructions of the another. It depends. See, at this point in the design, it is not important to define how the information is exchanged, either this way or this way, that is up to you, or mutually understandable or commandable, we don't know, right? So need to answer, is the information pulled or pushed? Whether it is taking the data, whether it is giving the data, pulling, pushing, or is it passed a message or call parameter? That is, are you going to pass or giving, that is pushing, or taking parameter, anything, pulling, you have to check that. Next. So at this point, only the information itself and the producer is producer consumer roles of interest. Who is a producer, who is a consumer? Which model will be, act as a producer, which model will act as a consumer, or vice versa? Okay, so this is this information is not solved by the ad at the higher level, because we don't know about the modules initially. How can we solve? Yeah, after getting into the system only, after debating of the modules only, we can know. So which one is going to work with which one, under it is working under, or it is along with, like that we have to check. So these steps should be sufficient to gain confidence that the system can deliver the desired functionality. That is enough. And see, represent the architecture with views. See, we have three views for anything, if you observe. Okay, common views. Module decomposition view, how to divide that, how to if there is any concurrency working. So one module have to work along with the another model, concurrency. Next, your deployment. Is there anything to deploy your data to any function after working that? Okay, deploying means assigning of the work or storing of the work. So all this we have to check in. How many views we have? Module decomposition view. These modules have to work in terms of a concurrency. Second one, and finally deployment. So we completed A, B, C, D. Different interface of the child models. After dividing these modules, after in terms of first we identify the drivers. Next we identify the pattern. Which one we have to start with? Next we identify the instructive modules and functionality. Okay, in terms of three views, right, which we discussed. And now we have to start with the interfaces, communication. So anything interface can be in terms of services and properties. Based upon your property, only one can communicate with you. Based upon your service you want to give, you can go to communicate with you. Or if you want to take anything, you are going to communicate with that. Okay. So this is different from a signature. Signature means it is not modifiable. It is not change. It will not change. Just static, but should be dynamic here. Okay. It documents what others can use and what they can depend. Documents, it is, we have to write its total features of this interfacing communication in advance, right? So I have to prepare well to, you know, communicate with you, right? I have to interface with you to deliver my lecture. So I have to write everything. It should not be static, right? So if you want to take an example at the instant, I have to take and convert you based upon the circumstance, based upon the concept I am going to deliver to you, right? So different interface views, the model view documents, what it contains. It contains in terms of interface, whether it is a producer or consumer. Okay, what are the patterns they want to interact with them? Concurrency view, as we have three views, right? One is a model, one is a concurrence. Okay, next. So interaction threads, we have lot of threads, ma. Which thread we have to work with another component? Okay, if there is any active part to start threading work, and is there any synchronization? Okay, we learn about the synchronization and parallelism in the previous classes, right? That is about the concurrency. And deployment view, what the deploy we can do, means deployment means the storing or accessing or any processing. What are the hardware requirements you have? What are the timing requirements you have to meet? How you have to communicate? So these are all called as a deployment. And finally E, verify and refine use cases. Use cases mean where they can use, we have to verify that. Okay, so based upon the use cases, means where we can use, means those requirements are functional requirements, the constraints, and finally quality scenarios. Everything based upon the three things, that's it. What is your function? What are the constraints to reach this function? If you're able to satisfy this constraint, what is the quality you are going to get? So these are all nothing but the requirements. Functional requirements. One is the user interface to recognize the request of the door opener. Okay, what is the raising lower door opener if it is so? Yeah, we have to check that it is a raising or lowering. Obstacle detection, that is one function, right? Yes, either recognize when an obstacle is detected and either stop and descent of the door or reverse it. Communication virtual machine, that is verifying internal data, manages all communication with the home information. Sensor or actuator virtual machine, yes, it have to work. So, sensor taking input, presenting. Okay, so manage all interaction with the sensor and actuators. Scheduler, have to check which one we have to start with. Then finally diagnosis. Manage interactions with the home information system devoted to diagnosis. If there is a diagnosis you want to perform more based upon your requirement, you can do. Okay, constraints. See, any constraint means functionality only constraint. Based upon the functionality, you will get the constraint. Okay, how many we have to divide? How many modules you want to divide? First thing, if you want to divide, whether it is a single child module, all thing you want to encapsulate, all the features you want to encapsulate in the single child only. Okay, because after division you will become a parent and the new one is called as a child. So you want to divide more that child further, third step or third generation, if you don't want to do, you want to include all the features in the single child only, that is encapsulation only, binding. Third one, the constraint is satisfied by multiple child modules. You have to check. If it is so, how they are working? Multiple child means single child, whether it is a client server or a friendly nature, we have to check. Quality scenarios. See, quality scenarios means the total, how they are working. See, our quality scenarios are our device and the controls, that is opening and closing of the door, okay? How it processor is working, whether it is identifying obstacle or not, whether accessible for, can predict any problem. That means it is giving some alert regarding charge, for example. If the charging is over, the door have to convey to us in terms of a red light blinking. If it is so, it is a, we can diagnose a problem. If it is no, if it is sitting idle, how can we know? Okay, so all this we have to check. Finally, our third step is repeating the same. So what are all these, ma? What does it mean? All these are all called as attribute driven design steps. First, what is decomposition? Third one is, in second step we have five steps. What is the first step? Identify the drivers, finding the pattern, setting the functionality, checking the interaction or interface with the childs, and finally the quality attributes views. Okay, yes, okay. And third step is after second finishing, repeating the same till we get nothing. That's it. So for today, that's enough. Tomorrow we will discuss the third topic of second unit, third and fourth. Both are small, this one is little bigger. Okay, so till then, have a nice day. Bye.